Hola, my amigos, Reddish and Amigo here, and welcome back to Let's Play Crash Bandicoot. And in the last episode, we just got those gems. And we're trying to find where the purple gem is. Because I had to close the guide, because I thought that was why my frames kept dropping, but no, it wasn't. Because my. By frames dropping, I mean, drastically, I kept getting frames dropping about 100 per second. It was really weird. Well, more than 100 per second, like 200. So, we're continuing Crash Bandicoot, and this is going to be fun. We've got another one of these light missions. I know we haven't got a gem here, so... Dude! Okay, I'll meet you there in a sec, guys. I don't even know. Okay, I'm gonna keep some of that in. I think I just went way past the checkpoint now. Whoops. Yeah, well. Yeah. Welcome back. This is Crash Bandicoot still. And I forgot to welcome you back with the... That was really weird. It's like, I don't know, it like all glitched up there, but... Here's the yellow gem and it makes us travel upwards. There's some boxes up here, I think. There you go. And the level is complete. That wasn't too bad. I think we get a purple gem out of that. Better be. Because I don't want to play that, the boulder level and then realise, oh, you need the purple gem. Yeah, we got a purple gem. Alright, 97%. I'm just gonna see what levels we need gems for. We need two more gems. Okay. So, what levels are they? I might save the boulder one till last. Because if it's my favourite, I'll play last. Okay, no, it's not any of these. Okay. Oh, I think I know where it is. I think it's the one before the boulder, or Road to Nowhere. Is that? Yeah, there is. I'll play Road to Nowhere, then we'll play the boulder one. This one has a pretty cool place where the gems are. Well, fine. Okay, this isn't the one we have to go to the back of the level. It's good. Okay. Alright. Yeah. This is just another one of those bridge levels. Yeah. It's not. I'm not gonna say it's really difficult, but it is like. It makes you scared, in case you're gonna fall. I feel that a lot with this game, which is why my commentary like goes downhill. Well, I don't know. Do you guys like it? I'm not sure. At the moment, I just feel that it's not as good, but I might be wrong, and you guys might like it. So. I don't know. Yeah, this is really cool, this gem, okay. It takes you over to here. Alright. And then you think, oh, this gem here, you take it. But no, it takes you back there. You have to go across here. And there's a little puzzle here. It's really cool. Okay. First, we hit this. Boom. Yeah. And then we got this one here. Okay. We're gonna... do that, and then we got this button here, which pushes that, and it lets the lights up here, and a mask, which is cool, very cool. And then you jump on this, and you get TNTs. This is that this exclamation box up there spawned another TNT, so you can hit it. All right, now let's head back. You can hardly see the gem. They're very like see-through-y in this game, which is good. They look better in the ones after this game, but I still like the gem design in this game. I like it how they actually like went with the actual gems that you stand on. In the new ones, I think it's a platform that's the same color as the gem. But we'll get to that when we get to the new games. Well, by new games, I mean 2 and 3. Not Titans and Mind Over Mutant. I don't know what they look like in that. I don't even think they've got any gems in that. Could be wrong, but I haven't played it, so I don't know. It's a turtle. Wait, just checking. There's no gem here. Okay, cool. Let's bounce. Oh, this is the one where you have to bounce on all the turtles, isn't it? Okay. Probably gonna fall then. I don't know why, but I like to be in the middle, because... Oh, okay. There isn't that much turtle bouncing. But this bit's annoying. Okay. Dude. Okay, I'll meet you back there. I'll just meet you back where the gold got. I was about to say the gold ring is. At the end of the level. Yes. Oh shit. I forgot to commentate. Oh well. We're back. Oh. Oh my. Oh well. Well, we got another gem. Crash is happy. And we got one gem left. And then we've 100%ed the game. And we're going to be playing my favourite level. That's going to be the last proper level that we play. Because the Great Hall doesn't really count as a level. It does count as a level, but I wouldn't say a proper level. Because you don't, like... You basically can't die unless you're really bad. And by bad, really bad, I mean really, really bad. I mean, not like... My bad, as in like being bad at the game very badly. I mean, even worse than that, because even I haven't died on that level. Alright, well, we're playing the boulder level that gives me Indiana Jones vibes whenever I play this. Okay, carefully, we gotta replace this Wampa Fruit with a box, okay? Go! Right there! Oh no, the boulder's chasing us! Da 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 da. Indiana Jones is dead. And look, it's the best number in the world, 64. I bet you thought I was going to say something else there. But I'll meet you in a second, guys. I think I've just done it again. Yeah, we're back. Why do I keep doing this? I keep thinking I'm actually playing the game. And I'm not used to, like, not talking while playing a game. Like, because I have to restart the whole level all over again whenever I die. So, I keep thinking I'm playing the game normally. Which is weird though, because the music's playing from my headset. And it doesn't usually play from my headset when I play a game. So I don't know why I think that, that I'm not recording. But, oh well. Oh my god. I hate snakes! There's a snake in my boat! Reach for the sky. You're my favorite deputy. Apparently this has gone from Crash Bandicoot to Indiana Jones to Toy Story. It's not a laser. It's I'm a firing my laser. Blarg! Oh, thanks for showing me that Lorelei music. You should check out Lorelei music. He does some good Let's Plays. Yeah. I'll put a link to his channel in the description. If I remember. If I don't remember, then Someone remind me of something. Because this is going to be edited and then recorded way in the future. Okay. I'm probably going to get killed by this thing. Oh, phew. Okay. Okay. There better not have been anything up there. Wow, that's a lot of extra lives. Oh yeah, look at the guy on the side. It's Nitro's Brio. Go away, Cortex. It's Nitro Brio. It's Nitro Brio. There's more Nitro Brios than Cortex, isn't there? Yeah, it's just Nitro Brio's better. 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 But yeah, let's just finish level. Yeah. Look at that. I don't think we can get 99% on this game. As soon as you get 99%, it goes straight to 100 because it just likes doing that. But nevertheless, we got the last gem. 100%! Perfect! Oh yeah! Save the game now, and now we've got 100%, and we are gonna head to the Great Hall and see the 100% ending. This let's play is almost over. It's hasn't been too long of a let's play, but like it's kind of like a short let's play, except for it's been dragged out a bit too much because I'm putting it on the weekends. Unless Mario Galaxy 2 is finished by now, but I don't know because this is being recorded on the 18th of September. Wait, no, it's September. Yeah, the Great Hall and Cortex. If you want the 100% ending, you want to go to the Great Hall. And the level will load. And you will see a load of gems as soon as you spawn, and you basically just jump gem to gem. I like the music. Music's good. Alright, now you just jump gem to gem now. And like I said earlier, if you die on this level, you suck. Seriously. There's Tuana there. Hey Tuana. See, Cortex does like Tuana. He even like put up a little poster about her in his own castle. Whoa, I almost fell there. I have a feeling I'm gonna fall, and then after I'm gonna get a load of comments saying that you suck at this level because I said that people suck at this level if they die on it. There she is. Riding a duck. I'm on a duck, mother ducker, don't you ever forget it. Here we go. Flying away on the duck. Quack, quack. I'm just quackers about this duck. So punny. But yeah, we just beat the game 100%. And you know what that means? No more crazy crashy. That's right. We've just got Crash Bandicoot, Tuana, and our good old duck. This Papu soloed the ruins of the castle, Cortex, to a resort developer. He then used the proceeds to open a big shop and tool shop on the island. That's what Papu did. Okay. After intense therapy and 8 years of higher education, Dr. Ru went on to write the Hell Received book, Through the Eye of the Vortex, a studied evolution of Cortex. I think that's what it said. Cola Kong moved to Hollywood and landed a motion picture deal of Universal proportions. Currently, he is working with a speech therapist to improve his diction. I don't know why, but is that? I'm not sure, but are they like referencing King Kong here? Because, like, they're making a film of a massive ape. It's like, I don't know. Pinstripe moved to Chicago, where he now owns and operates a city-wide sanitation company. He is saving money for his upcoming gubernatorial campaign. Oh. After the disappearance of his mentor, Dr. Nitro Spriel, he rediscovered his first love. Tending bar. No, Nitro Brio, you're awesome.
Thank you.
The world has heard nothing more of Cortex since Crash foiled his plans. But evil geniuses are harder to squash than cockroaches. And that's the end of the game, guys. But yeah, I think Papu, he does appear in one of the games. I know that. I'm not gonna say which game it is, and nobody say in the comments about it because it might spoil it and stuff. So yeah, he's in one of the games, future games. Cola Kong isn't. Ripperu is. You actually see him in his little outfit with where he was writing the hell novel thing through the vortex, the vortex is actually a big thing to do with a series. Like after this game, it was like it was a minor thing in this game, but after it's like a big thing. But also Nitro Brio. Well, we'll see him in the future. Pinstripe, we don't see him, sadly. I don't think so. I'm not sure. Cortex, we see him as well. So that's good. But we're on a duck. We're on a duck. We're on a duck, mother ducker. Don't you ever forget it. Yeah. And this is basically just the same credits as it was last time, except it's got a different background. Instead of the sunset, it's got a duck. And the credits are almost over. And my frames are going up drastically. Alright. Well, Crash can scream us. It may be lagging, and I'm sorry if it is. But, thank you for watching this LP. It's been a lot of fun doing it with you guys. And I'll see you guys next time. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.